Hey guys, this is Claudio Giuliano, Art Director of Artstudio Pro, and today I am really excited to give you guys a demo of our new version 2.2. We have been working on 2.2 for a while now. We've put a lot of hard work into this update for you guys, and I'm really excited to demo all of the new features that we have built into 2.2. I want to show you where these big evolutions are in the software, and I want to show you how it really changes things, and it really takes the software to a completely new level. So I'm really excited to get into that today, and we're going to get started right now. So I would like to start with some of the user interface changes and some of the new things we have going on with UI in version 2.2. So one of the really cool things that we have going on with UI with 2.2 is the new light theme. And I want to show you that right now because it does bring a totally new feel to the software when you switch the light theme on. It's really nice to kind of have that contrast. And I've been using the light theme a lot myself and I really enjoy it. So this is the look with the new light theme. We also have a new preferences layout. It's much easier for you guys to get to specific settings that you need to, important stuff. You can get to that much quicker now with the new layout. So a big major evolution that we have brought to Artstudio Pro 2.2, and this is a big one that really changes the software, is the new per brush and global pressure curve options. You are now able to completely control your pressure via the graph. And this is now going to allow you to get a wide range of dynamic results. This is going to give you the precision and feel that you want when it comes to your specific hand and how you like things to feel. You're now able to achieve any feel that you would like in the software by setting your graph. So this is the new graph, and I definitely suggest that you check the new graphs out because this is very enhancing to the software, and it's going to be very enhancing to your workflow and really your feel when you're actually in the act of painting or illustrating. Now we balance the global curve out by giving you per brush pressure control, except we really went the extra mile here and we built this into the brush system, really into the core of the brush system, because now you can control every dynamic that the brush system offers via the pressure graph. So you can set the graph for many different settings, and this is going to allow you to get a wide range of new results that you were not able to achieve in any previous version of the software. This is a pretty big game changer for the software, and it's going to allow you to achieve a new precision that you just couldn't get in the previous versions. So this is one of those areas of major evolution that we've brought to you guys with 2.2. And that brings us to the next major evolution, which is we have completely rebuilt the ink system from the ground up. This is one of the areas where I spent many, many hours working on with my team to bring you guys this new ink system. So now you can achieve natural, realistic ink results in Artstudio Pro 2.2. And the kinds of results that you can now get in 2.2 were not achievable in any previous version. Really enjoyable to ink with. And if you are a comic artist, if you are a fine art inker, if you're doing a lot of line work with ink, I really think you're going to notice this brand new ink system. You are also getting three brand new signature index brushes that come stock with the software now. They were designed in unison with the core of 2.2 and the core of the software. So I'm showing you one of those right now, which is my signature sable. If you go to the ink category, you'll see the new sable brush. And this is a great way to get to check out a lot of the new core foundation of the brand new ink system. So check out the sable. You'll see a lot of the new features that I'm talking about here. So I've been laying lines down here, and now we're gonna go in and quickly ink something. And I want you to take note of a few things as I lay these lines down. One is you can see how crisp and natural the result of the line that's coming out. You can also see the precision. Right now I'm going in, I'm changing my cursor to one of the new options, which is this new triangle option, which is really fun to use when you are inking. So when you guys dive deep into 2.2, I think you're going to feel this. I hope you are, because a lot of work went into rebuilding this. A lot of hard work went into rebuilding this ink system from the ground up. So we're going to keep inking. We're just going to go in completely random right now, improvised on the spot, because I want to show you a couple other things when it comes to feathering and the results that the new sable brush can achieve. And that's why I want you guys to check this out. But there's also something else I want to show you, because I think a lot of you guys don't realize that you can now do this with Artstudio Pro. We built this in actually with the previous version, and I want to show you how you could take advantage of this. A lot of times what I do when I'm inking or coloring or doing this kind of line work, I also have to work in the negative. And as you can see here, when I pull up my pop-up menu, I have erase blending set in my pop-up menu. The new erase blending mode is the equivalent to working in the negative, so you don't have to actually switch into the eraser to work into the negative. So that's how I like to set things up when I'm inking. I have the erase blend mode set to my pop-up menu so I can quickly pop that up, go into the negative, and that is how I achieve that workflow. I just wanted to show you that really quick. And that now brings us to our next major area of evolution, which is the new paint engine and the new blending system. So in the previous version, in 2.1, we actually built in a new setting that is called blend transparency. And we put this in 2.1 as a placeholder, but it really now all comes together with the way that we have built the engine and blending system for 2.2. So it allows you to create much more dynamic and natural results. You are able to get a much better blend than any previous version. And since it's built from the ground up, you're going to notice that difference. And I want to demo this for you with the two brand new paint index brushes that are included with 2.2, and they were designed with the core of 2.2 in unison with it. And if you guys check these two brushes out, you'll really get to see where we took things with wet paint and the blending system. And then also we get that layer on top with all of our dynamics having those pressure graphs and controllers. So right now I am demoing things with the Giuliano blend brush. And what I want you to take note of is how quickly the render is being brought forth, the depth in space, how beautiful the blend is coming. You can see how I am mixing the transparency and white of the canvas right in. And you can just see how much more natural things are when we begin to render. And this is very much in part due to the new system that we have built. Now, when I go to the Giuliano oil texture brush, you can see that same kind of blending happening, how quickly I'm building the form. But now you can see the stark contrast between these two renders here. And that is in part due to completely rebuilding the foundation of the paint system, but it's also due to the new settings we are giving you, which I was pointing out before with the blur radius option, and the Giuliano oil texture brush is using the flat blending option. And we spent a lot of time working on this and getting this right. And you can see the stark contrast between when flat blending is on versus when it is off. And this now allows you to create a much wider range. And the flat blending allows you to really sculpt with the paint. And as you can see, works great for grayscale, also works great for color. So this is another area in 2.2 that I spent a lot of time on with the team. And we have completely rebuilt the painting system. And now you can get a wide range of beautiful dynamic results. You can check out the two new paint index brushes in the wet painting category. And we have made absolutely no compromise on performance or our optimization, which is what we are known for. And as you can see here, the speed of the brushes, nothing has slowed down. Even with adding all these layers and levels of complexity to the software, we have been able to achieve this without any compromise in performance. So that is another reason why this is so big and why this is so game-changing all around. Now I want to show you the next major feature, which is you now have the ability to blend all of the under layers non-destructively. And I want to demo this for you and show you how you're going to access this. So again, I'm just going in, painting totally at random, improvised on the spot here, and I'm going to now demo this for you. So to access this ability, and this is big because, again, going back to not compromising on performance, to pull this off in the way that we have, there's really nothing else out there like this. So when you go to your More panel, you now have the ability to set your settings to sample all layers. You have a variety of options here, but in order to achieve what I'm going to show you, you're going to want to set this to sample all layers. As you can see, now I have put layers above that base painting that I laid down. And what's going to happen now, since I have sample all layers on, when I start painting, it's going to be as if I was on this actual layer that the core was painted on. So as you paint, you can blend right into the painting now on the above layer. All of your under layers will now blend in, and it's going to do this non-destructively. As you can see, when I turn the layer off, you can see the core has no destruction. Nothing changed on the core. Why is this so big? Well, it's so big because it allows you to implement a completely new experimentation when you are painting, being able to not destroy the underlayer. It's going to allow for endless experimentation. And this is going to be great if you're just learning how to paint. This is also great for seasoned professionals, for concept artists who have to get work done quickly. Having this ability is really big. And as you can see, when I was just painting there, when I turned it off, you can see that, you know, nothing on the underlayer was blending in when I just sampled the current layer. So this is a really big, big feature. And it's even bigger because of the performance. We have no setbacks in performance here. You can see our optimization shining through. You can see with the size of the brush I'm using here, you can see the speed, no lag anywhere with this ability. So it's a really big game changer, and it's going to change your painting game in Artstudio Pro. It's going to change your painting game all around. It's a really big feature, and it's another one that we spent a lot of time working on. So I want to continue demoing this for you, and now we're using the Giuliano Oil Texture Brush, and I want to just show you these results and how it works with this as well. So again, I am on that above layer, and now I'm painting in a more free way, knowing that I am not destroying any of the core underlayer. So, you know, it just really allows for ultimate experimentation as I do this. I can go in, I can change things around. As I'm painting, it's just a more worry-free way of painting, and it's just really enjoyable when you have this option. But it's much more enjoyable when you're able to do this with this kind of speed, this kind of performance. It just really changes the game all around for painting, in general, from the big picture point of view. So this is one of my favorite new features in 2.2, and I'm really happy we were able to pull this off in the way that we have. Also, if you've noticed, I have been doing these wet paintings with the symmetry tool. This is a new feature built in 2.2. You can now wet paint with the symmetrical tool. And again, we've achieved this without compromising the performance. Now, we have a lot of other new features in 2.2, and I can't get into all of them today, but we're going to be coming out with a lot of brand new tutorials on how to master the software that I think you're going to enjoy. A couple other things before we close I wanted to point out. You can now set your display color option for your canvas. So for example, I have mine set to the P3 display to get the wide color gamut. We now have customizable keyboard shortcuts here. We give you a lot of options here to get all the customization you need to create those workflows if you are using a keyboard setup. So we put that in there for you. We also have a variety of new filters that I think you guys should check out. One of my favorites is the new halftone filter, and a variety of other new great things built into 2.2. You know, what it comes down to is we also build the software for ourselves as professional artists, illustrators, and designers. And for 2.2, we wanted to take the software to the next level and really give you something that enhances your workflow and takes all of your workflows to the next level when it comes to painting, illustrating, sketching, inking, designing, everything that the software offers. So I really hope you enjoy 2.2. We put a lot of work into this, and I really can't wait to see what you create with it. I want you guys to stay tuned for the in-depth lessons that we have coming. We have a whole slew of new content coming for you guys. Thank you for tuning in today. I want to say thank you to all of our testers who have been testing for us, and we will be back soon. Have a great day.